All right, still your guy Big Tank from Double South, and we see the run of CSS Mastermind in IDB. So this tutorial, I want to talk about the CSS box shadow. And if you see my browser here, and I just get one small box web like that already organized, what can work for you now? And I'll carry on, I'll go into my code now. What I do right, I just the styling for the box, and you see I'm assistant to royal blue for the background color. Then make the width and height be 300 pixels. Then I say margin left 200 pixels and margin top 200 pixels. So that the thing will suspend for the center small, like it's not the center sharp, but at least it will come aside from the corner in IDB now. So, what I could do now for this box shadow, I'll just call my CSS now. I'll give small space. I'll say box shadow. So the box shadow now, I could specify the X offset. That is X and Y as is now. You know that's for Mazda here. So I'll say the X now. I'll put like 10 pixels for the X axis now. Then I'll say another 10 pixels for the Y axis. Then the blur. I'm going to make the blur be like, Marjorie make the blur make bigger so that this time I'm going to see. Then I'll just put the color of the shadow. So when I put it on, I'll save. Go back to my browser. So if I refresh now, you see what happened. Show you the C shadow now. See and see. This one, I will see the shift, the condis, right hand side now. Now it be the X axis. Abi? Hope I know it's how to talk so. And now it be the X axis now. Why the one for, why will I say the shift, the condis top or the bottom now? Now it be the Y axis. So, my just increase and small, so I'm not gonna say. Now the X axis that talk now, Abi. My can go like 50, more than see and face. So if I refresh now, you see I say the X axis output now, see I say that shift come now be. So I'll carry the Y axis now, enter like 40, mass go shift enter. If I refresh now, see I say the shift come down now. You see now? Then this other one now, see I say it's not sharp. If I change this 20 now to like maybe mass it two now, go back, I refresh. You see I say that sharp now be. That are the blur. So the blur now they make the thing they get that that feel make the scene like a shadow now this thing. You know this kind of times shadow feel not sharp. You get when sun hot when a shadow the sharp. But when the sun not hot when the shadow feel not sharp. So now something like that they happen here now. So if I want me the shadow sharp now, I go decrease the value while they put for the blur here. But if I don't make it sharp like that now, I got to increase now. So if I say like 30 self, so you go up on now. So I blow away now, you get. So simply put now so you see the wrong box shadow. So what I go do here now, might just reduce this thing now. This may not be like say with the query for the shadow. My reason like 5, make it look something interesting. Take this to enter like might just put all the 555, most of it go happen. 555. This has to be now. It'll give that small look and feel now. But to the use with this kind of black now for shadow now, not to make me think too sharp. What do we do? We come out this sharp color now. Use one to call ROGBA. You get ROGBA. So what is ROGBA they do now? This arrow stands for red. This one so. This arrow it stands for red. The G stands for green. Why the B stands for blue? Why the A stands for alpha? So if I say 0, 0, 0. You see what I'm saying? That's still the solid black now you get. If as much shift it comes as small as here. My shift and comes as small. You see, that's the solid black. But if I come this alpha now, cost maybe like a because I need to make this alpha make the value very very small. The alpha they try to like the add transparency to that color now. You get. So if I come here now, I turn the alpha now, I see maybe like 0.1 more suit to go up on. You see, I say, you know, you see the shadow again. Now. See, you see, now. I don't even black shadow, but you need to see. So I can't come for this 0.1 now, I go take until like 5.5. You get. You see, I say, it doesn't take shape, it doesn't black the way shadow to be now. You see, so I'm gonna take these things and go back to the 5.5 now. We'll see. You see, I said that get that look and feel of shadow now. You get so just like that. You know how to know. Now it's box shadow. Now box shadow now be this now. So now do it the runner for CSS. Now so it be. But if I go leave now, I want just show now kind of quick way because now they confuse this kind thing of teaching now. So where they want to apply for inside web design. So I just show now one quick thing that I show now if you do. When I feel that this style button. Now feel that this style button. So quick now just create one button. I go say click. I'll say click me. Most style the button small. So it's I'll do. I'll come here and say button. I'll target the button now. I'll say more copy this too. So that the button will see float come outside and I get. You see? See the button now. I don't say it's small over here now. Shall I wanna bear with me? I'll make it big now. So I'll come here to make it big now. I'll say padding. On the right away. I'll say padding and the value I'll give her now, I'll say 10 pixel for top and bottom, why 20 pixel for left and the right. Then I'll transform the text now, say text transform now. I'll transform the text to capitalize. So each word that the first letter now will capitalize. Then I'll just say font family. This font I'll put down on my system now installer. So if you're not doing your own, I'll say mother. Then now on a later video share, I go show now how to use custom fonts. You get a very key thing for web design. I'm gonna make your site fresh. I'll show now how to use custom font. So you see now my border be gray, then the cursor, make the cursor be pointer. I think it'll be so that by the time you hover your mouse, you see the way that they hover this cursor now. It seems now one kind of line I show. But when I say cursor pointer, when I hover the mouse of the button, I could show that hand so that at least you go no say na click, then one click this thing. You get so I'll come here now, refresh. See, as my button dot there now. See, as over now, it show the hand now. Meaning, say I won't click this thing now. Which is that the click now be this. You know, if you just look at your face, you get so. To see, make it much more interesting now. I'll come here and say, button, I'll give a hover state so that by the time this cursor now the hover I'm inside this button now. The styling now, web like see inside this place now for this hover. Now I can call it affect this button that time. So now see, so imagine say maybe I want the background color now. The background color may change to red by the time they hover on the button now. You see, I say go affect her. She is saying by the time they hover now, it change to red, but nobody won't be that. So I'll just make this one ash CCC. I'm gonna put on set for this one. You get okay color like that. So by the time I hover now, you see I say it shows so okay, then I sound to able I say that they click. You see so. So what I go do now, I will give this thing box shadow. In fact, I might just copy this one now. I'll give a box shadow. I'll copy this one. I'll give a box shadow. So you see, by the time they click now, the thing be like with raise. The button now be like with raise come off for the raise come off for the browser. You see so. In fact, to make it much more interesting, I'll add a kind of small animation port now. I'll say transition. I'm not too bad on myself for this one. I'll teach you now later. I'll say transition. I'll say all and 250 milliseconds is in out. I'm not worried, sha. On a very good day, I'll go run this one for now. But not me now. So now when I refresh now, you see I say if I click, you see this thing they come smoothly now. You see? So it's not a very fine effect if you use now. I think on your now say this one will should come out for you now. So I don't really want it like that. That means the one will see come out for the X axis. I don't really want it. So if you come here now, turn out to like zero. You see? Either should come. Okay. Now the Y axis now. Can you imagine? Now the Y axis now go to Nepal with. So I'll come up for here now. I'll go refresh and I go over. You see now? Only the button and now the shadow the show. You get. If you don't send me the shadow the show for what you need to do here if you get that kind of situation. If I'm not showing for this one for here now, I'll change this color now to the complete block. So then I go see away. For you to do one like that, you don't say if I say box shadow 50. So I say shoot come outside. So if I want me this shadow now, maybe the other side now, which is on the left hand side, I'll just go and I'll say minus 50. You see, negative value. It goes shift and call this other side. And this other one, say, probably I say and like 50. Where the shift come down. If I want shift and make it up now, I see negative value I go put now. And go shift and go the other side. So you see now. So I don't try for this video. And now so CSS box shadow B. Now so CSS box shadow B. Not pass like this. Not every time you go use a shadow, but at least it could mean you know see one cat like this, the one side for the CSS now there exists too. You get in IDB. So I say me a lawyer boy big tank from Dubsouth. And the next tutorial, I go teach you on that correct stuff. Thank you.